Hey guys, and welcome to Petrolped, and welcome to Turweston Airfield. Now I am here with the guys from Revo. Behind me is a stock Audi RS4, a stage 2 tuned by Revo Audi S4 B9, and a runway. I feel some drag races coming on. So yes, it's not many times you get access to a very beautifully smooth tarmac runway and a couple of very high performance Audis. Now I have had this S4 on the channel before. Last year I came up to drive it. It's a stunning, stunning thing. And it's running about 485 PS and 637 Newton meters of torque with a full stage 2. If you want to see the video on this car, put a card above right now. But we're going to put it up against, this is a B9 S4, we're going to put it up against the very latest 2022 RS4. This is a completely stock car. This car is running 450 PS and 600 Newton meters of torque. And I think it should be a really interesting test. So what we're basically going to do to spice it up and make it even more interesting is I've got the guys from Revo with me so we can actually take the tune off of this car and run it as stock. So first up, we're actually going to put these two cars up against each other, completely as stock. Stock RS4, stock S4. And we're going to do three tests. We're going to do a standing start quarter mile. There are a set of cones a quarter of a mile down the runway. We're then going to do a rolling start quarter mile. So going over this start line about 20 or 30 miles an hour. And then I'm going to get my RaceLogic V-Box and do a standing 0 to 60 test. We'll then put take the stock tune off of that and put the stage 2 tune on it, bring it all up to its top numbers and do exactly the same thing again. I have a feeling today is going to be really interesting. I've got a runway all to myself.
So first up, first thing we're going to do is actually take the tune off of this car so it runs stock, apart from the hardware obviously, and then we'll reflash it with the map. And then it'll be running stage 2 and should be quite a difference. Luke's looking very concentrated there, so he's getting prepared for the big day ahead. How's it gonna do, mate?
I think we'll be alright, you know, I think it's gonna be tight. You know, the twin turbo on the RS4, I feel like that sort of allows for a little bit more top end.
Yeah.
But I'm confident in our calibrators, the hardware obviously.
Well, we've got the hardware guru and hiding around here, we got the software guru as well. Not only our starter today, but also the guy who wrote the software that's running on this car. So it's all up to you, my friend.
Just put my launch control on.
I'll do the same. Done.
Now then. Let's start this with a stock RS4 and
a stock S4.
A stock S4. So we're going to do two tests. We're going to do a standing start 0 to 60, and then we're going to do a rolling start 0 to 60. Then we'll do some 0 to 60 tests with my RaceLogic V-Box. And then we'll put the map onto that so it's running its full stage 2, and we'll repeat the tests again. Standing start, rolling start, 0 to 60. Should be interesting, this. Are you ready, my friend?
Ready.
Is the starter ready? Prepare to go down.
I got a feeling.
Okay,
ready?
Yep.
Ready?
Okay, ready? Yep. Ready? Okay. Oh, look at that. Destroyed him. Absolutely destroyed him.
Yeah, that's pulling.
Going over the line. Oh, he was gone.
I think you might have done me.
I think I did you there. Just put the. Let's do a rolling one. Now that. that's no massive surprise, if I'm honest. Ultimately, that's a B9S4, and this is the latest RS4. This is running 450 PS, so it's got way more power than that. That's only running 330 PS, so of course this car was going to pretty much destroy that one. So that's probably the least surprising test of the day. Rolling start might be a little bit different. Let's give that a go. I have a feeling though, when they put the tune on that, having driven it when it's got its stage 2 tune, I think it's going to be a very, very different story indeed. Are we ready?
I think that's where we're going to be.
So rolling start, 20, 30 mile an hour, so cross the line, hit the cones, floor it.
With it.
Ready?
Just gonna put the sat nav on.
So you know where you're going.
Yeah.
Right, let's go. Although what is interesting is I crossed the line at 120 again, so it just shows how good the launch is. Gearbox on, that's fast. This was laggy.
Try it in manual.
Yes, let's do a manual one.
Yeah. So I'm second gear.
Oh, okay, hold on. Second gear, yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Three, two.
Go. Yeah. Smashed him.
Didn't like that.
Okay. Stock RS4. Stage 2 S4. You ready for this one, my friend?
I think so.
On the count of three.
Okay, three.
Come on! That thing's rapid, look at it! Come on! I'm catching it a bit! Just 120 miles an hour! Wow! Off the line, that is rapid, man. I just caught him at the end. Wow! Okay. Damn, that thing's fast now it's got the tune on it. Flipping heck. Right, next, rolling start, 30 miles an hour. Damn, I have to speed up for that, that's impressive. So standing start was close, my friend.
Very.
You had me off the line, and then I just came back at you right at the end.
Oh no, it's just that extra bit.
Is that the racing ballast?
100%. Without breakfast.
Rolling start?
100%, let's go.
So
we
go rolling start, I'll do 3, 2, 1, windows up, and then 20, 30 miles an hour as we cross the road, and then pin it. Right, 3, 2, 1. Lost a gear, he's got me, come on, I'm just getting him back, I was in auto, schoolboy error,
Now that's what you call a TCU tune.
I was in auto and it just didn't kick down quick enough.
TCU tuning.
What's that stand for?
It's all the gearbox control module. So we do all the gearbox tune as well as the engine tuning. Much faster shift points, proper manual modes.
You left me wanting there, mate.
On that one it was. That was impressive. I was pleased with that.
Oh! Damn! God, that car's quick. Okay, let's set a 0-60 benchmark in the RS4. Traction control fully off. RS mode set. I'm in sport mode. Launch control. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, that's quick. Come on, baby. Oh, that's gonna be tricky to beat. Gee whiz, 3.36. Blimey. That's a bit quicker than Audi quote. That one, that leapt off the line like a scalded cat. 3.36 seconds. Wow. Safe to say, the Revo S4's got its work cut out. Okay, so we've had a benchmark time set by the RS4. So I'm now in the Revo S4, but it's running stock. We've taken the map off, it's running stock. I'm in sport mode. I've got everything turned off. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Go. Oh, come on. The sound feels a lot more stock. Come on. Yeah, there we go. 4.14, which that's actually still faster than Audi quote as stock, because I can remember when I had my S4, I think the quoted time was about 4.5 seconds. Oh, it might be 4.9 actually, so that's still quicker than Audi quote, but it's quite a way off what the RS4 did. The big question is, how much difference to that number will putting the tune back on this car make? Let's find out, shall we? Okay, now a 0-60 test in the S4 with the stage 2 tune. Feeling this might be quite dramatic. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Go! Oh, 3.59. It's pretty good, isn't it? Wow.
Well, that was a good day, wasn't it? Above average day when you got a runway to play with.
I would do it again, definitely.
Surprised? Not surprised?
Not surprised, I think confirming things more so. Yeah. That is a weapon.
They are.
There is no doubt about it.
Stunning,
that is a great
things.
Stock car.
Yeah. I mean, these, if we talk about the stock test first. So I actually said in the in-car that these were 333, but that was the B8.5, the supercharged one. These are like just over 350, aren't they?
354 PS, yeah.
So you're bound to, there's like 100 PS difference. So
easily,
stock
yeah.
off the line test, I had you completely.
Oh, without doubt. There was there was not even any getting it back at that point.
The rolling test was interesting though, because what we didn't do, we took the tune off of this, but we didn't take the engine the gearbox calibration out.
TCU tune was left in it, yes.
Yeah.
Completely stock ECU. So back to the 354 PS, but we left the TCU tune in it.
Yeah.
And like you say, on the rolling start, you can really see the difference.
So much quicker. So much quicker.
Very, very snappy. The kick down, the gear changes themselves, everything else, even manual mode to sport mode, everything else. That was interesting. I have to say, that was a surprise just on that with the stock ones.
Yeah.
But it didn't take long for you to
No, I reeled you back in, and then the 0-60 test, again, not a great surprise. A little bit less than Audi quote stock.
Yes.
But it all got interesting when you put the tune back on, though.
That's what we do.
Oh, my days. So, you know, I drove this car last year on its own in isolation on a public road, and you kind of can't really tap into it.
You don't get the full sense of urgency, I don't think, from it. Even if you do a launch on the road for a brief period, you don't get that when you have that.
No, and we just pinned it. I mean, I was doing 120-odd by the time we crossed the quarter mile. But the three tests we did, the standing start, off the line, you were just unbelievably rapid off the line.
Considering without launch control, and it's almost like boost building on the brake, you're having to hold it like it wants to creep.
Yeah.
And I'm holding it as much as I can, and I'm putting a full 133k into that brake. But, you know, I think that was the difference. When we saw the RS4 launch, it launches.
Yeah.
As opposed to the way that the S4 almost just picks up instantly. It's just got a sense of urgency about it off the line straight away with traction and everything else.
Yeah. And then by the time we got to the end, I kind of got you but by a bumper.
I think it was bloody close.
I know.
I'd like to see the final. I think we need a good final photo there. That's a photo finish for sure. But
rolling start, same story. The gearbox just kicked down so quickly, I literally just bogged down. I think had we been on the paddles, maybe I'd have been a little bit more with you, but that was where I lost that one. But for me, it's the 0-60, the times. That stock is way quicker than Audi quote, but you guys were super pleased.
Yeah, anyone
that's
bought one of those is going to be very happy.
I know, But your time... Yeah,
over the moon with it.
I came in and I was like, come on, Luke, what do you reckon? And he's like,
high threes, I thought.
3.9. Yeah. It's like, got to be happy with that.
I think any time you're getting a car sub 4 seconds in a family saloon, I mean, what would you be unhappy about with that? I mean, you're supercar sort of territory at this point, aren't you, really? Like anything the sort of 3.5 seconds, it's quick.
For sure. But sadly, the day has come to an end. There's some guys over there that are just about to take a Hayabusa down that runway.
I think they're about to make us look
350 slow. Horsepower on a Hayabusa. Should we go back?
Not for me.
Let's go back for tier medals.
I think so.
Thank you so much for the invite today.
No,
it's been a superb demonstration of the cars. I hope you enjoyed that one, guys. I would love to do more runway tests because I really enjoyed that. If you want me to try and get access to a runway more often, put it in the comments below. I put all of Revo's details in the description of this video.
Yep.
Check them out if you're interested. As I said, hopefully by now you've watched the video I put out about their ST Focus running 410 horsepower. It's parked just over there, by the way. If you enjoyed that one, give me a thumbs up. Comments below are always welcome. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to Petrol Pedal for plenty more content to come. And we'll see you in our next film. Should we have one more rundown?
One more.
See you on the next film, guys. Drive safe.